This is the African Stonehenge. At least that's what some are calling it. And it predates the famous British Stone Circle by at least 2,500 years. It was discovered in the 1970s at a place called Nabta Playa in the Egyptian desert. And it turns out that this wasn't just one single site, but a whole complex of structures built over a period of thousands of years. But what makes this place so special is what's in the sky. Archaeologists uncovered stone circles and other alignments that seem to track the movements of the stars, including the brightest star in the sky, Sirius, part of the constellation Orion's belt, and the summer solstice. So this site functioned kind of like an astronomical calendar. And nearby, they found other structures like tumuli or burial mounds and sacrificial remains, which suggests that this place had a strong ceremonial function. Perhaps the people who built these structures used them to track the celestial cycles, perhaps even predicting when the Nile would flood each year based on Sirius's annual rising, which always occurs just before the flooding begins. Or maybe they were used to watch for the return of the dead, a bit like our own modern-day Halloween, where the veil between the worlds is at its thinnest. And because human beings throughout history have been fascinated with the cycles of life, death, and rebirth, perhaps Nabta Playa was also a fertility site where women came to give birth under the watchful gaze of the cosmos. Some researchers even think that Nabta Playa was a precursor to ancient Egypt, where people first developed their unique cosmology and ritual practices, which later spread to the Nile Valley and took root in the black sands of time. So what was Nabta Playa? An ancient calendar used for farming, a ritual site for fertility, a warning left by a prehistoric civilization for us to see in our modern times, or all of the above? We don't know for sure. But what we do know is that the builders of Nabta Playa watched the stars more closely than almost any other prehistoric culture we've studied, leaving us a legacy of stone that allows us to do the same. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. See you next time.